Hello friends, it's Shan here. Welcome or welcome back to Golf with Shan. 12 years ago, as I was getting more serious into the game of golf, I had a chipping lesson with a former LPGA golf coach. In 10 minutes, she changed my short game forever. She taught me a method of chipping that I have been using to this day. I'm gonna pass that knowledge on to all of you watching. Now, of course, there are no methods of any shot in golf that is fail-proof. Even the best in the world make mistakes. There are, however, methods that dramatically reduce your likelihood of making mistakes. Like I've said before, I like to keep it as simple as possible on the golf course. So here is how I was taught to chip as a 12-year-old and how I teach my friends now who are new to golf and sometimes act 12. Let's go. For 10 years now, I've carried two wedges in my golf bag. These are the only two clubs I use within 70 yards of the green. I don't personally like to switch it up too much. I don't really hit bump and runs with higher irons. I just use these two clubs. So I have a 56 degree with a 10 bounce and a 60 degree with a 13 bounce. So these are pretty high bounce numbers, but personally I find that I get better spin control and they glide through the grass better on softer surfaces. That's just a personal preference. If you are new to golf, you don't have to worry about it. If you are new to golf though, and you purchased a set of irons, it will usually come with an S wedge. That stands for sand wedge, and those are usually between 54 to 58 degrees in loft. Anywhere over 58, you get into the lob wedge category, and that's where you can hit those high flop shots. Phil Mickelson, notoriously good at that. I love my 60 degree, but for beginners, I would not recommend going with such a high lofted club because they are a little bit more difficult to hit. But once you've played more golf and you've gotten really good at chipping, I would highly recommend getting a lob wedge and join the fun. All right, I'm gonna walk you guys through the chipping stroke in here with a 56 degree and a ping pong ball, and then I will actually demonstrate on the golf course and show you a few shots that I actually hit on the golf course. Alright, I'm gonna walk you guys through step by step, so just follow along. It's very simple, trust me. So we're gonna start with our feet shoulder width distance apart, knees slightly bent, arms straight down, just like we would set up. Again, if you haven't watched my setup and grip video, go check that out. So we're gonna set up just the same as you would any other club. We're gonna have the ball centered in our stance, so the ball is going to be right down the middle. We're not gonna complicate anything. Everything is the same so far. Set up, feet shoulder width distance apart, knees slightly bent, arms straight, ball positioning centered. One difference here, I do like to choke down on the club. That just means instead of gripping down here near the bottom, I move my hand up. So this is what we call choking down on the club. So that's the only difference. Now that we're here, ball is centered, knees slightly bent, shoulder width distance apart. We're gonna shift our weight to the front foot. So if you are right-handed, you're gonna shift your weight towards your left. If you're left-handed, you're gonna shift to your right. The reason that we wanna shift the weight to the front foot is this creates more stability in your chip. So this is the only difference. Ball is still centered, your weight is just gonna shift to the front and it's gonna stay here for your entire chip. You can almost just chip on one leg. You know, this is a drill you can do. We're gonna keep both feet on the ground, ball positioning centered, shift our weight to the left, and that's it. That's how you're gonna set up for your chip. Now, imagine you are doing a putting stroke. So very simple, just a back and forth. No wrist action here, okay? We're not going like this. Arms, everything is one unit around here. Just gonna rock back and through, back and through. One more step. On the way through, we're gonna accelerate a little and lift our back heel up. Let's run it through from the top and then I'll show you guys on the golf course. Feet, shoulder width distance apart, knees slightly bent, arms straight, setup position. Ball is going to be center of your stance. Center right here. Shift our weight to the front. And then putting stroke, except accelerate. So straight arms, no wrist action. Back and accelerate, just like that. All right, now I'm gonna show you guys on the golf course. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful to you. These are genuinely the instructions I got as a 12-year-old from a former LPGA golf coach. It is also how I chip to this day. If you've watched any of my golf vlogs, you will probably have noticed I do actually chip like this on the golf course, and I will continue to. Chipping is one of the strongest parts of my game. I feel very confident because from the start, I was taught to keep it simple, and it's just a simple motion that has lasted me through the years. Of course, once in a while, I will mess up around the greens, but overall I have to say I feel so confident about chipping, much better than putting. I hope that after watching this video and after some practice, it will become one of your favorite parts of the golf game as well. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, check out my other beginner-friendly golf videos or some of my golf vlogs. I will see you in my next one. Bye!